Snapdragon 8 Elite could have some heating issues. Elite reports told us that Realme GT 7 Pro could not finish a 3D Mark benchmark. And recently, other YouTubers also showed that they burned their hands playing games on Asus ROG 9. This contradicts many claims that the Snapdragon 8 Elite is more power efficient than the Snapdragon 8 Generation 3. Today, I will systematically check whether the new Snapdragon 8 Elite is power efficient or it gets hot. I will also use the app that I wrote to measure the battery life and the temperature. The first number is battery percentage, the second is battery temperature in Celsius, and the third is battery temperature in Fahrenheit. I will use the Xiaomi 15 and Galaxy S24 Snapdragon for this test. Both phones have similar form factors. Since the Xiaomi 15 is the smallest Snapdragon 8 Elite phone, it is a good benchmark for seeing if the new powerful chipset can handle compact phones. I saw the test by exporting a lengthy video using Adobe Rush. Before opening the application, both phones had a similar temperature of 24.5 Celsius, which is 76 Fahrenheit. Halfway through the export, the Snapdragon 8 Generation 3 reached above 30 degrees Celsius on the left side, and the 8 Elite stayed 3 degrees Celsius and 5 degrees Fahrenheit cooler. The Snapdragon 8 Elite finished the task in 7 minutes and 44 seconds, reaching the maximum temperature of 31 degrees Celsius, 87 degrees Fahrenheit. The Snapdragon 8 Generation 3 completed the task slightly later, in 8 minutes and 18 seconds, and reached 33 degrees Celsius and 91 degrees Fahrenheit. We have three main takeaways from the test. The new Snapdragon chipset finished the task earlier and stayed 2 degrees cooler. Looking at the temperature chart during this task, you can see that the gap was widening, and Xiaomi 15 remained relatively stable temperature-wise compared to the S24 Snapdragon. If you look at the power consumption chart, where the x-axis is time and the y-axis is the power consumed in units of watts, we notice that the red line is consistently below the blue one. This means that the new Snapdragon in red is using less power. On average, it used 8% less to finish the task. The next simple task is to play YouTube videos on 5G for around half an hour. Again, both phones started with a similar temperature of 27 degrees Celsius, 80 degrees Fahrenheit. After 15 minutes, the S24 Snapdragon 8 Generation 3 was the first one to reach 30 degrees Celsius, while the Xiaomi 15 stayed at a degree or two lower. By the end of the test, the S24 Snapdragon was around a degree Celsius, which is 2 degrees Fahrenheit higher than Xiaomi 15 with the new chipset. From these two tests, we can conclude that under normal usage, your phone doesn't get hot and it doesn't have any power inefficiency. But what about if you put the phone under the load and stress? I'm gonna do a couple of synthetic benchmarks and I will also do a gaming test. The first test I will do is Geekbench, which puts the CPU under load. I'm also curious to see how much improvement the new chipset has made. Snapdragon 8 Elite finished the task earlier and reached a maximum temperature of 30 degrees Celsius, 91 degrees Fahrenheit, while the older Snapdragon 8 Generation 3 reached 35 degrees Celsius, 95 degrees Fahrenheit. We can compare the power usage here since one got a much better score. The new chipset got 9345 for multi-core, which is 40% improvement. Nice. I'm now going to do the 3D Mark benchmark, which we get the early reports that the Snapdragon 8 Elite got some heating issues. This benchmark puts the phones under 20 loops of heavy use. On the fourth loop, the Snapdragon 8 Generation 3 was averaging 85 frame rate, while the new one was getting 130, which is a 50% improvement. It is kind of crazy. The Galaxy S24 already reached 42 degrees Celsius, which at this point, the phone starts to throttle to keep the phone temperature low. The Snapdragon 8 Elite on the Xiaomi 15 had a great performance and stayed 2 degrees cooler than the S24. But what happened next will explain the controversy. While the S24 was doing a good thermal management, the Xiaomi 15 did not throttle the chipset properly and let the phone run as wild as possible. Towards the end of the test, the S24 reached 45 degrees Celsius, while the Xiaomi 15 surpassed 51. To make matters worse, the Xiaomi 15 was unable to finish the test, and on the 19th loop, I got an overheating error and I had to stop the test. Let's look at the charts together. The first one is the temperature. Here, red is the new Snapdragon and blue is the red one. As you can see, the blue started to rise much quicker than the red one, but then the Galaxy S24 started to throttle earlier, which led to the phone staying more stable. Meanwhile, the Xiaomi 15 was not aggressive enough in managing the power of the chipset, and it just let it run wild to 50 degrees Celsius. The second choice is the power consumption. Over time, the red is the new and the blue is the old Snapdragon. In the beginning, despite having better performance, the Snapdragon 8 Elite used less power than the 8th generation 3. Over time, the power consumption stayed high, but let's not forget that the phone gave 50 to 100% more performance compared to the Snapdragon 8 generation 3. And it is about chip management rather than the chipset not being efficient. I am gonna run AnTuTu next to see if we have the same observation there. And the observation was similar. Around 60% into the test, the Galaxy was 3 degrees Celsius hotter. But since it throttled earlier, by the end of the test, Xiaomi 15 with the Snapdragon 8 Elite got hotter. Regarding the score, the Snapdragon 8 Elite got 2.6 million, while the Snapdragon 8 Generation 3 got 1.7 million. I played 15 minutes of Genshin Impact on both phones for the real gaming test. Both games run on max graphics with the same frame rate. By the middle of the test, the Snapdragon 8 Generation 3 got to 36 degrees Celsius, while the new Snapdragon stayed at 32 degrees Celsius. When the test was finished, the old Snapdragon 8 Generation 3 got to 38 degrees Celsius, which is 100 Fahrenheit, while the new Snapdragon only got to 34 degrees Celsius and 93 degrees Fahrenheit. Neither of them had any frame drop in this 50 minutes test. Let's look at the charts together. Looking at again the temperature chart, the Snapdragon 8 Generation 3 got hot much faster and the gap broadened as the test went on. Looking at the power consumption chart, the new Snapdragon 8 Generation 3 stayed significantly lower throughout the whole test compared to the Snapdragon 8 Generation 3. It basically used 25% less battery during the game on average. I can already predict that the Galaxy S25 Snapdragon supposedly is gonna outperform the Galaxy S24 Exynos by a very high margin. I wouldn't be surprised if I see, let's say, 30 to 40% better power efficiency, and the battery life will be like 30% or 40% better if they use the same battery milliampere, basically. If they use the same capacity of like 4000 battery, I can already predict the Galaxy S25 Snapdragon is gonna be much higher. So if you are in a position that you want to buy a new phone, I would probably wait a bit. If you want to buy Xiaomi 15 or one of these like Chinese phones that are already out, go ahead and buy one. I don't think any of them have an actual power consumption issue or an actual heating issue. At first, I thought maybe the vapor chamber has a problem, maybe it's a software problem, but the reality is that they are just not throttling the phone early enough. That said, I made a full comparison of Xiaomi 15 versus iPhone 16 versus Galaxy S24 Exynos and also Pixel 9. Also, we have chipset comparisons there. If you enjoyed this video, you can watch that video next. Thanks for tuning into Techmo, and I will see you in the next one.